Part 17, types of insurance. Mainly two types of insurance, life insurance and general insurance. Insurance refers to a contractual arrangement in which one party, that is insurance company or the insurer, agrees to compensate the loss or damage sustained to another party, that is the insured, by paying a definite amount in exchange for an adequate consideration called as premium. Types of insurance. Types of insurance mainly divided into two: life insurance and general insurance. Life insurance again divided into two: whole life insurance and endowment insurance. And general insurance divided into three: goods transportation insurance, fire insurance, other general insurance. Goods transportation insurance again divided into three: train insurance, air insurance, railroad insurance. Other general insurance is divided into insurance against loss, health insurance, insurance against theft, animal insurance, group insurance, sports insurance, vehicle insurance, third party insurance, credit insurance, insurance of loyalty against fraud, accident insurance, insurance against natural calamities, employees compensation insurance, employer compensation insurance. Life insurance, whole life insurance. When a person who is insured dies, the insurance company undertakes to pay a pre-decided sum as a compensation to the legal heir of the deceased according to the contract or an agreement. It is known as whole life insurance. The insurer has to pay periodic premium which is to be paid throughout his life. Life is precious and hence there cannot be any price decided for it. An insurer decides the value of his life and his capacity to pay premium. In this case, the principle of indemnity cannot be applied at the time of death of an insurer. If the death is not unnatural, the insurance company has to give the full amount as per the contract to heir of the deceased. Whole life insurance, the insurance contract wherein insurance company promises to pay the stipulated amount to their heirs of an individual at the time of insured is called whole life insurance. In whole life insurance, the principle of indemnity is not applicable. Principle of indemnity means the loss being occurred due to the cause against which a risk insurance has been taken, the same is indemnified by the insurance company, that not belongs to the insurance company. This insurance amount is based on the premium. As per the capacities of different persons, that premium going to differ. Life is precious and hence there cannot be any price decided for it. An insurer decides the value of his life and his capacity to pay premium on the basis the insurable amount going to decide. And second one, endowment insurance. When the insurance company promised to pay the policy amount to the insurer at the end of the policy period to him or to the legal heir in the event of his death, it is known as endowment insurance. In return, the insurer pays a pre-decided amount as premium periodically till the duration of the policy. When the insurance contract is such that if a person reaches certain age, he will get stipulated or already decided amount as per the contract. Otherwise, in case of his death before that age, his heirs will get the insurance amount. It is called endowment insurance. Insurance person will complete his premium amount. After that completion of that premium and given years, he will get that already decided amount. Otherwise, in before this completion, this person will die, then his or her legal person will get full amount of insurance. This is known as endowment insurance. General insurance. General insurance are three types: goods, transportation insurance, fire insurance, and other forms of general insurance. First one, goods transportation insurance. When goods are transported from one place to the other, there is a risk of full or partial loss or damage. There are insurance policies for such risks, which are marine insurance, air insurance, and railroad insurance. First one, marine insurance. Transportation of goods through sea route is very economical, but it is risky and slow. In the 18th century, most of the international trade used to take place via sea road. Hence, it is a very ancient and widely used form of insurance. Lloyd's of London was the first to start marine insurance. This company has maintained its image of loyalty for more than 325 years. And second one, air insurance. With the advent of 19th century, the movement of goods through air commenced, which also led to the beginning of air insurance. Air transportation is too costly and risky, hence highly valuable and lightweight goods are transported by air. The premium for air insurance is much higher than marine and railroad insurance. Third one, railroad insurance. Land transit involves rail and road transit of goods. The most important form of risk involved in such a transit are theft, dacoity, and damage to the products, etc. Insurance is a form of protection against such a risk. In general insurance, there are mainly three forms: goods and transportation insurance, fire insurance, and other form of general insurance. In goods and transportation insurance, first one, marine insurance, it is very ancient and it is very economical also, and along with it is very slow. Air insurance, it is originated in 19th century and it is costly compared to other insurance. Then rail and road insurance, the insurance can be taken for transportation through railroad transportation. The rate of premium for this mode of transportation is higher than marine insurance and lower than air insurance. Then another one, fire insurance. It is promised by the insurance company to pay compensation against the full or partial loss or damage to property due to fire. Against a pre-decided amount of premium is known as fire insurance. It is based on the principle of insurable interest. The insurer should get compensation equivalent to the loss of value of property due to fire, provided he has insurable interest. The contract to indemnity against the loss caused by fire to goods and property is called fire insurance. The specific insurance premium has to be paid for that. It follows the principle of insurable interest to protect the damage of various things, to make compensation against damage especially happen by fire. This is known as fire insurance. Principle in this fire insurance, the principle of insurable interest going to applicable. Other general insurance. The business of insurance has grown with the time and new types of insurance have come into existence. Insurance of the voice for a singer. Third party insurance to give compensation because of use of vehicles to others. Insurance for labor compensation in case of accident. Insurance of laborers. Employee insurance. Student insurance to protect general and social damage. Medical insurance or health insurance to compensate for medical treatment. Insurance against loss caused due to the closure of a business unit, insurance against loss due to fraudulent activities by employees to employer, insurance against any cancellation or postponement of any entertainment programs or sports events, either due to a natural or man-made risk, are some of the types of insurance. Medical insurance is to compensate for the huge medical expenses incurred by a person in the event of any health problems, as against periodical premium paid by an insurer to an insurance company. Over and above this, insurance can be taken for the risk of loss by the causes like earthquake, robbery, theft, accident, war, etc. Lot of new types of insurance has come into existence. The insurance encouraging savings for higher education or marriage, insurance for of important limbs of certain persons, vehicles insurance, insurance for workers, accident, third party insurance, group insurance, etc. Health insurance, a promise is made to the insured to indemnity him for the amount spent on sickness as per predetermined conditions for stipulated specified period against specified premium period. Insurance is a contract in which an insurer promises to pay the insured party a sum of money if one or more specified events occur in the future, in return for regular small payments known as premiums. The purpose of insurance is to reduce your business exposure to the effects of particular risk. In this part, we studied about types of insurance, mainly two types of insurance, general insurance and life insurance. And life insurance is again divided into whole life insurance and endowment insurance. General insurance is divided into three: protection insurance, fire insurance, and other general insurance.